HB brought us. We huddled up and we're like, yo, we have to win this game, especially everybody thought he'd be ejected. So when that happens, you know, usually that team kind of comes together and goes on a run. But we were able to negate that, and I think we finished the game extremely well in those last few minutes.
Yeah, De'Aaron, Brendan Nunez, Kings Herald. Second straight really good game from Malik. Can you just speak to the importance of having secondary playmaking out there and how it makes the game easier for everybody but yourself specifically?
Yeah, I mean, he's been doing that all season. Obviously, we want him to do it throughout the season more consistently. But, you know, when you have, you know, some rest in between games, obviously, and also playing the same team twice, and you get to be able to adjust to, you know, coverages that they throw at you. I think he responded extremely well. I mean, him and Davion, obviously last game it was him and Trey. This game it was him and Davion stepped up big time for us.
De'Aaron, Tony Harvey, NBC Sports Radio. The last game, the Warriors had 31 assists. And that evaporated down to 18. What are you guys doing, you know, what do you guys do tonight, you know, to limit them, you know, in those passes and finding those open lanes?
I think a big part of it was Draymond. I mean, he had 11 assists in the first game. We go back, we make adjustments. And if he's in a double-digit assist type of game, then they're having a good game. They have a flow going to it. So we just wanted to be able to disrupt it. I think they said we had 24 deflections. How many steals? 11 steals, 20 turnovers. You know, I think we were just being extremely disruptive, trying to be physical without fouling. And I mean, I feel like obviously some guys had a good game, but I feel like we kind of disrupted the flow of their game.
Back here, Fox, Sean Cunningham, Fox 40. Obviously, it's an ugly moment with Draymond. I know you guys are really tight with him, and obviously with Sabonis. Does that change anything in your mind, seeing an ugly moment like that, and especially the way maybe he riled up the crowd after?
I mean, you know, going against him and some guys in this league, that it's going to get physical. Obviously, that shouldn't happen. But at the end of the day, we're protecting our teammate. And, I mean, that is what it is at the end of the day.
Mark Haynes, Sacramento Observer. De'Aaron, this is your second great playoff game, second game playoff game of your career. Is it safe to say that you're built for this?
I'll let the fans do that. But even so, like offensively, I think I had a decent game, 10 for 23, even though some people shoot 43% for the season. I tell Malik, yo, I can't shoot 50% every game. But for me, I think the big thing was, you know, the three steals. I think I had one block, but I thought I had two blocks. But the three steals in the block, I think, was bigger for us than me just putting the ball in the basket. And then nine assists, I think I had two turnovers. And I think as a team, we had two turnovers in the second half alone. So that was huge for us.
De'Aaron, Joe Davidson, Sacramento Bee. Can you talk a little bit more about Davion Mitchell and just his effort and his energy? And do you ever go against him in practice, and how's that go?
Yeah, he was big time for us tonight. Obviously, we all know what he can do defensively. He hounded Steph most of the game. And then, obviously, what he added to us today offensively was huge. The big three in the corner, honestly, I would say was like the nail in the coffin. I go against Day every day in practice. That's why y'all see what I do out here, because I'm not going against Davion out here. So he's made me a better player since he's been here. Obviously, he has the nickname Off Night, but I don't think people realize, like, how he moves laterally and then how strong he actually is. So, yeah, going up against that anytime we scrimmage or do stuff has made me a much better player.
Hey, De'Aaron, Matt George, ABC 10. I don't know how you feel about milestones necessarily, but this is the first time in the Steph, Clay, Draymond era that the Warriors have gone down 0-2 in a playoff series. Does that mean anything to you or to the team?
I would say for us, we knew that we needed to be better at home. And in these first two games, we protected home court. And I think that's about all we're taking from it. We protected home court. Now we have to go in their building where they're one of the best teams at home in the league and try to win a game.
De'Aaron, Jason Anderson from the Sacramento Bee. To follow up on that, how How much better does it feel to go up 2-0 at home, but as you go to San Francisco? How much more confidence does that give you than, maybe being in a 1-1 situation?
It feels good. It definitely feels good just being able to protect home court. I mean, that's what you play, the entire season for, is to try to get home court advantage as much as you can throughout the playoffs. So for us to be able to protect that, I think it's definitely huge for us. And, I mean, it builds confidence day after day, game after game. When you're winning a game in a playoff series, it makes you, it builds up your confidence. Obviously, you don't want to overreact or go into a game overconfident, but, I mean, you put yourself in that position. So you have the right to be confident. But we know that, we go and watch film. We go back to the drawing board. We see what we need to adjust on, and we play the next game.
Another game where the shots didn't really fall as much. How do you guys keep that offensive pressure consistently throughout when you don't see that ball go in?
I mean, the ball keeps moving. We got great looks. I think we just missed, and I think shots will start falling. But we continue to play the same way. Just because shots aren't going in, we don't stray away from anything. And I think we got to the basket a lot. We touched the paint a lot. We were able to get kickouts. And when they did go down, they were big for us. So you just stay the course. Just because you're missing shots, you don't change what you're doing out there.
Just want to get your perspective on Herter, how he's defending Clay. Clay did, get a couple big shots down the stretch and stuff, but just want to get your, commentary on Herter's work on Clay.
Yeah, Clay's going to make shots regardless of what's going on. I mean, a lot of times, especially in this league with guys and how talented they are, unless you're blocking the shot, then it's hard. You just want to you try to contest as heavily as possible and hope they miss at times. But Kev was big for us. Just being able to put pressure on him, be physical. Clay is strong. He pushes you to get you into screens, and I think Kev was big time for that. And I think he either blocked one or two of Clay's jumpers. So he was big on that end for us.
De'Aaron, Jason Anderson again from the Beat. There's a report here that Domas is undergoing X-rays on his ribs and his lungs after what happened there with Draymond. Do you want to speak to just the beating that he takes consistently and go any further as to what happened tonight?
Yeah, I mean, he's down there. Led the league in rebounding. He scores a lot of points in the restricted area. And he gets hit. He gets hit all game. He gets grabbed. He gets tackled. Obviously, at times he says something, but most of the time he doesn't complain. He gets up. He gets back on defense. We've talked about this before. That ignites a team. If your best player is down there getting beat up, and at times he doesn't say anything, he gets back, then everybody else knows that if something happens to them, if you may get fouled, then you need to get back on defense. So it's big for us. Obviously, we hope our brother is okay. We hope he's not injured. Even just outside of basketball, if you fracture a rib or punctured lung, like that's a serious injury. So we just hope for the best right now.
Downstairs.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, this is Davion over here, Jake Gayton from CBS 13. Congrats on a big game tonight. Truthfully, what do you think went into your performance tonight defensively and then offensively as well, the big three to close the game?
Yeah, I think throughout the game, I just tried to do a good job of putting ball pressure on Steph, trying to just keep running around with him. I know he's definitely a hard task to guard, especially with their team, looking at him throughout the whole game. And offensively, man, they just told me to keep shooting open shots. Shots wasn't falling in the beginning for us, but if we keep shooting them, eventually they'll go in.
James Hamm, ESPN 1320. Davion, just the three in the corner, how big is that for you and your confidence and your development here to have a shot like that in such a huge moment in the playoffs?
I mean, it's big. I mean, my teammates had confidence in me throughout the whole game. Malik kept telling me, you're going to hit the next one, you're going to hit the next one. And as soon as I got the next one, I just trusted my work and I just shot it and it went in.
Hunter Patterson with The Athletic. Davion, most people usually kind of love getting buckets. So what is it for you specifically that you enjoy so much about trying to make life hard for others?
Yeah, I think that, I think a lot of people look at basketball as it's kind of all about offense, but it's really not. It's the little things you do defensively, rebounding, little things like that. Offense is definitely a big piece, but in the playoffs, it's going to be tough. It's a lot of physicality. A lot of calls are not being made, I mean, just because it's the playoffs. So I know you got to be locked in defensively, especially at times like this.
Matt George, ABC 10, back here, Davion. First off, do you hear the ovations that the crowd gives you in mid-possession when you're able to stop a drive and attack to the basket?
No, not really. I mean, I'm kind of just – I try to stay locked in. I don't really pay attention to it like that.
And then you hear a lot of buildup coming into the playoffs that playoff defense is different. What is it about this team that's been able to figure that out so quickly with the defensive intensity that they've brought?
I think just being ready, physicality, just being ready for it. We knew that it was going to be a lot of fouls that in the regular season would be called, but not in the playoffs. So we knew we should be ready for it. They're not calling a lot of things, but I think we did a really good job of just staying poised throughout the whole game with it.
Davion, it's probably an easy question here, but does that feel like the biggest moment of your career?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, I played in big games in my career, but I think this is definitely the biggest moment playing against the defending champs.
And just how did you view the moment with Draymond and Sabonis, and how did you kind of digest that?
Honestly, I didn't really see it. I seen it, like, afterwards. Those plays like that, you can't really it's hard to judge from that. I mean, especially because, I mean, the game's physical throughout the whole game. Things like that we can't really control. So we just try to go on to the next play, man, and just keep playing our game.
Scott Marsh, Sactown Sports, 1140. You guys helped to keep Steph to just 3 of 13 from beyond the arc. Anything specifically in guarding Steph tonight?
Try to limit his shots, limit his touches. If he do touch it, just make it hard. Throughout the game, just keep a body on him. Keep pushing him. I mean, eventually he's going to get tired. It's definitely hard for him not to get tired, but eventually his legs are going to weigh down and his shots are going to be short. So we just try to do that. I think we did a really good job on that today.
Joe Davidson, Sacramento. Do you enjoy going against De'Aaron in practice? He complimented you a moment ago, and also the challenge of Curry. You certainly seem to enjoy that.
Yeah, I think these moments is fun, especially the biggest moment of, I mean, basketball in the NBA playoffs. Playing games like this is always fun because every possession matters. So you get a stop that matters. So it's definitely fun.
Tony Harvey, NBC Sports Radio. Davion, of course, this is a different situation, but you guys have been a pretty good role team all season. Just want to get your thoughts of, you know, going into San Francisco to play these guys and what you have to do, you know, to get that job done, at least come away with one win.
Oh, yeah, it's going to be tough, especially because, I mean, we're up 2-0, so we know they're going to come at us. Even tonight, they came at us throughout the whole game. We know a lot of calls probably not going to go our way, but we just going to be prepared for that, be ready for it, and just keep playing our game, keep being physical, and just keep on to the next play.
Davion, Sarah Hodges, CBS 13. I'm sure you saw the J.R. Smith comment and then about guarding Curry, about Delly.
Yeah.
And De'Aaron Fox just talked about it on Saturday, but did you sort of feel like that, like you need to take an ice bath, maybe an extra long ice bath after guarding him?
No. I think that I love that end of the floor, so I'm really fine with it. I mean, it's a challenge. I mean, definitely run around with them. Getting through those screens, a lot of screens is I'm getting hit on, but I mean, I'm kind of used to it. I'm getting hit throughout the whole season with screens, so kind of used to it.
Davion, Jason Anderson, Sacramento B. Apparently, Domas is getting x-rayed on his ribs and his lungs. We've seen him kind of take a beating like all year long. Do you, any thoughts on just kind of the physical nature of not only the season but the playoffs and seeing him kind of get beat up that way and to see that happen to him tonight?
Yeah, man, Domas is a monster. He throughout the season, he played through injuries throughout the whole season. He didn't complain. He didn't sit out. I mean, he put us in a position where we can be in the three seed. He put us in that position because he played most of the game. So, I mean, shout out to him, man. He's a monster. I hope he's okay.
Yeah, Brennan Nunez, Kings Herald. Davion, you guys have been kind of up and down defensively throughout the course of the regular season, but two really good games now on that end in your first two playoff games. What do you think has been the difference that's allowed you guys to take that to another level, especially with how many small ball lineups you're rolling out there?
I think that the coach is telling us even before the series we got to be physical, and I think as we up our physicality and made our defense stronger, it made the passes tougher. I mean, just because we're always bumping them, so they don't get easy looks. I just think we're just connected together throughout the whole game. Appreciate it.
Man, what a game! The physicality that both teams brought tonight was unbelievable. I thought our guys did a heck of a job tonight. You know, to see that they had 22 turnovers and we were able to capitalize off those turnovers was huge. We got to keep having active hands throughout the ball game and. Try to get as many deflections as possible and hope those can turn into points going the other way. We keep talking pace. We got to keep playing fast, 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 even faster than what we play tonight, because that's how we play. We generate a lot of points just by us pushing the ball in transition. But on top of that, you know, having a pace about our game in the half court, too, has to be huge. our ability to offensive rebound in game one and tonight was big, you know, especially, you know, we're obviously not shooting the ball like we normally do, and that's part of being in the playoffs, but we want that thing, we want to let it fly. We want our guys to let it go. If they see a hint of daylight, let it go. We trust them. We believe in them. They've been shooting the ball well all year, and we know we're going to have a few games where we really break out. When we do, if we can keep that same physicality and sense of urgency that we're having defensively, it can turn into a big, big, big win for us. What was huge was also for us in the second half is we had two turnovers in the second half. We had 12 in the first half that you know, kept them in it, gave them a lot of life. And for us to be able to be strong with the ball, we talked about the game being a physical game, so you had to be strong with the ball, especially when you tap that paint. For us to be strong with the ball like we were in that second half and only end up with two turnovers was huge. You know, you take your hat off to Foxy, big, big, big buckets down the stretch. He had a big three right in front of our bench that was phenomenal. Domas, he's an all-star, and he showed tonight why he is an all-star, and he should be all-NBA like Foxy. Both those guys really stepped up tonight, and they were big for us like we need them to be. I tell you what, our bench with Malik continues to be aggressive, continues to play the right way. We need him to be aggressive like he is because, you know, I don't know if I've seen a guy, especially a six-man like that, be able to make plays the way he does for himself and or for his teammates. But Davion Mitchell was good. You're not stopping Steph. You know, Steph had 28, you know, and when a guy scores 28, you think that somebody did a halfway decent job on him. But, I mean, Steph is the greatest of the great. You're not stopping him. You're not going to slow him down. You just want to try your best to make him work, and that's all Davion's doing. He's trying like the Dickens to make Steph work, and we know Steph's going to bring it down in San Francisco. He's going to let that thing fly, and we all have to be conscious of trying to help Davion or Foxy or whoever's guarding him, because he can win a series for that team any day of the week. But I got to give credit to Davion for trying to fight over screens and through screens and all that other stuff. I don't know if he can do a better job, which is, again, a testament to Steph's greatness with the 28 points. So phenomenal game. Our crowd, again, I don't feel like I've ever been in a building that's as loud as this. It's deafening. My grandson has come to two games. I gotta ask his mom if we need to get a nanny, because I'm worried about his eardrums, even though he's got these big old things on his head.
Yeah, James Hamm, ESPN 1320. Mike, it's a great win for you guys, but it's kind of marred by the situation with Draymond. Have you seen a player stomp on another player like that and then, again, go and goat the crowd, stand up on the scores table or the bench area and do what he did like tonight? And I know you know him personally. Just what are your thoughts on that entire scene?
Yeah, I didn't see what he did afterwards. But for sure, it's a flagrant two for sure, and it'd be interesting to see what the NBA does after they review it. But I didn't see the aftermath.
And Dylan Moss, is he all right?
I'm not sure. I'm not sure. I think he might be getting checked out now, getting X-rays and all that stuff, because it was pretty hard stomp.
Sam Amick, The Athletic. Mike, you talked pregame about when these guys win in the playoffs, you just kind of let it ride and you're, you know, loving them up. But you go into this postseason, you didn't know what you'd get from each of these guys. And to win a game like this against that group, when you're talking about the drama like with Draymond and the grit aspect of it, is there part of you that takes a step back and is pleasantly surprised and enjoying the way they're stepping up here?
I am enjoying it, you know, because like you said, like I've been saying, you know, we've had a good regular season, but we haven't been on a stage like this. And, you know, you think that it's going to go a certain way because they played at a certain level throughout most of the year, especially when they were on the road and in tight situations. But you don't know until you experience it. And, you know, there's going to be a lot of firsts for us, a lot of tests for us. You know, every game we win in a situation like this, it's going to get harder because they're first of all, the reigning champions. They have a championship DNA that is irreplaceable with as many guys, and including their staff, that have won at a high level. And so every loss, in my opinion, is going to make them that much more desperate, which in turn, it's like I said it before, it's like a wounded animal. That wound is just getting bigger and bigger, and when that happens, we know and they know they're going to have to crank it up a notch and fight even harder. So, it's going to get tougher for us each game.
Mike, through two games, I mean, you guys have shown kind of the ability to remain composed in high-intensity situations, and I think that altercation kind of would fall into that. How much do you feel, I know you're speaking for yourself for a minute ago and seeing the altercation, but how much did that maybe bother your team and maybe, you know, upset them in this game?
Yeah, I mean, nobody likes to see that done to their teammate, you know. In the same breath, you hit it on the head. We have to exceed their physicality on both sides of the ball. We have to play with a sense of urgency on both sides of the ball. But at the end of the day, there's a lot of stuff that's going to happen out there. And so we got to be smart with how we react, we respond, and our guys have been poised. And so I take my hat off to our guys because there's a lot going on out on that floor.
Tony Harvey, NBC Sports Radio. Coach Brown, after that scenario with Sabonis, Warriors come back. They tie it at 93, I believe, and 95 or something like that. And your team, you know, Fox hit a couple baskets. Just want to, you know, get your thoughts, you know, your team, you know, in that moment, you know, sticking with it no matter what and then pulling out the win in those last few moments.
Yeah, you know, we said this all along, you know, whether we're up big or we're down big, we have to stick to what our game plan is. We got to keep trying to play fast. We got to keep trying to be physical. And we can't worry about what the score is or how much time is left in the game. And, you know, they're a great team. I said it before. They're going to take the lead down the stretch. They're going to tie the game down the stretch. They may be in front down the stretch. Who knows? But we got to keep grinding and see if we can find a way. During this time of the year, you just find a way to win. And our